When Tony Richardson very generously gave me that 0.5% in at the end of Tom Jones, we went out and bought equipment to be able to make television films or any other movie, 60 millimeter. We bought an Eclair NPR, we bought an Agra, and we equipped the cutting room, and then Kate and I made these two documentaries almost back to back. The first one was called Dan, and it was about a gypsy who had recently been housed in a proper house, but whose most of his life was spent in gypsy caravans. And he had a stall in the Portobello Road, and Kate is in the movie saying, "Hello, Dan," or, and we could and then talking to him, and he comes out with all these wonderful anecdotes about how his eighth child was born, that they kept getting girls and they were trying for a boy, and the eighth one was also a girl. So he said, "Oh, well, when Babs was born," we said, "Yeah, okay, that's a lot." Stop there. And that film, what inspired me, at least in part, to make that film, was that we were uniquely placed to make that film, Kate and I, because Kate was an old friend of theirs, and Kate and I could perfectly well cope without having any other people involved. She'd do the sound, I'd do the picture, we'd have, the camera would be partly handheld, and at that time we still needed a cable connection between the camera and the sound, which caused a certain amount of friction with me and Kate. I was pulling on the cable and she was dying to say, "Stop it," she couldn't talk because the camera was running. But anyway, proved to be a very successful venture in those terms. And because it had occurred to me that if the BBC, say, were to want to make this film, first of all, they'd have to get to know Dan and his wife, who was extremely shy, although they lived in Aldershot, which is only, 10 miles from London. She'd only been to the West End three times in her whole life, and she was some 30-odd years old. So that's how shy she was. So a team from the BBC would have had to spend hours and hours, days and weeks getting ready to do that. And then even then, they wouldn't have had the same result because they would have arrived with their tripods and their lights and their assistants and their paraphernalia. And they wouldn't have the easygoing relationship that we can just sit down, get the camera out and start filming. So that was a point in making both that film and the subsequent film, which is called The Greeks, which is about the subject of immigration, emigration from Greece, partly temporary emigration in the form of guest workers. So that film is made half in Hanya and the area of Hanya around here, and half in Germany, in the area of Oberhausen, which I knew a little bit from the festivals. And again, it's made by Kate and me, two people, and George helped us on one sequence in Piraeus, which forms the end of the film, very dramatic climax, where a boat leaves for Australia and families are separated probably forever. So that again was very successful to make. And as I speak German and Greek, I could make it in Germany and in Greece without too many difficulties. And the first one was shown on British television in the Granada region only, though. And the second one, I mistimed the second one because it was ready just at the point when BBC Two, who were the obvious customer, would be BBC Two, and they just switched the colour and they wouldn't buy any more black and white films. So that I mistimed that one. But In my view, they were both successful, and the Greeks, the second film, The Greeks, has enjoyed a new lease of life where it's caused considerable interest here, but because it's become a historical document. It's made 30 years ago, so it's become a historical document, and nearly 40 years ago. Mm-hmm. And it might be shown on one day on Greek television. I'm still hoping. But it was shown during my exhibition of pictures. I had an exhibition of my photographs here recently, twice in fact. And it was shown during that, and it attracted quite a bit of attention and interest.